Are you a conscious creator of your destiny? Many of us may not even be aware that we may be unconsciously sabotaging our own destiny. Are you aware that you are not just your body alone, but you exist in many levels of consciousness? Our physical body is only the grossest form of our consciousness. Our consciousness extends through many subtle layers called sheets. We have a physical sheet or Annamaya Kosh, the vital energy sheet or the Pranamaya Kosh, the emotional or mind sheet or the Manomaya Kosh, the intellect sheet or the Vigyanmaya Kosh, and the bliss sheet or the Anandamaya Kosh. Now here is the catch. If we can just organize our mind, our thoughts and our emotions, then we automatically organize the other sheets, that is our physical body and our energy body. So if we can align all our layers of consciousness in one direction and continue to hold the alignment for some time, we can transform ourselves into a more cohesive, more energetic, and more efficient being. Once this alignment happens, you can virtually manifest anything you desire in life. But the problem most of us face is that every few moments, our mind keeps fluctuating in so many directions. We keep getting tossed up and down on the waves of emotion. We are sometimes happy, sometimes sad, sometimes motivated, sometimes depressed, sometimes full of energy, sometimes exhausted and dull. So with this state of our being, no wonder we are not able to reach any destination in life. We just let ourselves to be drifted by the currents of our subconscious mind. So by the end of this video, you will learn first the causes of our fluctuating state of mind. The second, the hurdles we face in moving to a coherent state of mind. And third, how can we transform ourselves into a magnet for abundance? So we shall be going really deep in this video into the layers of our subconscious and how aligning them could result in changing our lives. So if you have not subscribed till now, I suggest you subscribe to this channel so that you do not miss out on the forthcoming videos in this series. But before we start, let us pray to Lord Ganpati for all of us. Om Shri Ganeshaya Namaha. I call upon the lineage of my gurus to bless me. My heartfelt gratitude to my guru for choosing me as a medium to express himself. Om Ram Shri Nityanandaya Namaha. Om Ram Shri Shaligram Sharmaya Namaha. Om Ram Shri Kanayalal Sharmaya Namaha. Om Shri Gurave Namaha. So we humans are a combination of physical, energetic, mental, intellectual, and spiritual dimensions. Our thought patterns, our feelings and emotions, they strongly influence our expectations, our values, and our attitudes. Science is now catching up and validating what our ancient scriptures and the yoga philosophy had mentioned about the composition of our being. Now, it is very interesting to note that science now has evidence that matter is an epiphenomena of energy. It means when we change our energy fields, the cells of our material bodies respond to the changes in our energy field. I am sure all of us are aware of the famous equation given by Albert Einstein, E is equal to mc square. But The deeper implication of this equation is that matter is nothing but a condensed lower vibration form of energy. It also implies that the higher vibrational form of energy can impact the lower vibrational matter. So this important principle gives us a very potent tool to change our state of being. Of the five layers of our existence, or the panchakoshas, the physical body is the grossest layer, comprising of five elements or panchatattvas, that is earth, water, fire, air and ether or akash. The next layer of vital energy sheath has more subtler energetic vibrations. The mind sheath or emotional or feelings sheath is more subtler than the energy sheath. And then the intellect or the intuition sheath, Vijnanmaya Kosha, is still more subtler. And the bliss sheath or Anandmaya Kosha is still subtler. And beyond that, the one universal consciousness is the subtlest form of energy from where everything in this universe has manifested. So remember the principle that higher vibrational form of energy can impact the lower vibrational energy. That's why our Pranamaya Kosha or the energy body controls our physical body or the Annamaya Kosha. And our Manomaya Kosha or the emotional sheath controls both the prana as well as the physical body. So have you noticed how when you become angry and emotionally agitated, you breathe or your prana becomes so shallow? And this in turn impacts your physical body by attracting various lifestyle stress-related diseases. Similarly, our intellect or Vijnanmaya Kosha controls all the lower koshas. Notice the hierarchy of control. So, what do you think? What is the highest vibration of energy in the universe? You are right if your answer is the energy of universal consciousness, the energy of love, the energy of compassion, of gratefulness. Sir John Eccles, who earned a Nobel Prize for his work on the brain's neural synapses, says that we have to recognize that we are spiritual beings with souls existing in a spiritual world, as well as material beings with bodies and brains existing in a material world. So when we live as though we are spiritual beings with material bodies and orient our consciousness in the way that each day the matter we create with our minds is very, very different. So a brain scientist is not revealing anything new other than what Bhagwan Shri Krishna has said long back in Bhagavad Gita. Tasmat sarveshu kaleshu mam anusmar yuddhcha mayyarpit manobuddhir mam ev vaishnas sanshayam. So he says, keep your mind attached to me, that is the universal consciousness, and do your worldly duty with your body. So no wonder scientifically we are arriving at the one truth of existence, that aligning all our layers of consciousness with the universal consciousness is the most effective way to become the best version of ourselves, who would be capable of achieving anything we desire in life. But the problem we face is that our mind is a sense-oriented mind. By default, its orientation is towards the external gross world. Our indriyas or the 10 senses, they collect stimuli from the outside world and they keep feeding the mind continuously. Our indriyas are designed to get lured by the glitter of the world. If we do not exercise a conscious choice to reorient the mind inwards, away from the sense objects, it will continue to get drawn towards grosser objects. And this obviously creates imbalances in our lives. It creates disturbances in our emotions and creates diseases in our bodies. And to cure this imbalance, we only look for material solutions like pills or medication or drugs to make us feel better. That's why Maharishi Patanjali has mentioned, avidya asmita raja dvesha vinivesha klesha. This simply means that all the sufferings in our lives are owing to ignorance of our true self. When we consider ourselves as separate beings, acting through our ego consciousness, we are not able to reach out to the highest vibrations of universal consciousness. Our ego consciousness makes us forget that we are the sparks of the same universal consciousness. So now, when we know that by changing the energy, we can change the matter, we can implement the same in our lives. To cure your physical health, control your prana or your energy body. And you all are aware of the benefits of pranayama. If you wish to control your prana, try controlling your feelings or the emotional sheath or the manomaya kosha. But that is where most of us get stuck. We let our emotions rule us instead of making conscious decisions of how to respond to our emotions. We let ourselves be guided by our subconscious storehouse of vrittis and past memories. So if you wish to have control over your emotional sheath, try moving to higher kosha to utilize the power of vijnanmaya kosha, that is the intellect sheath. It is the power of discrimination, the power to decide between right and wrong, between what is meaningful to us and what is meaningless in our life, between what to take in and what to let go. Maharshi Patanjali says, Viveka khyatir viplava thanopayaha. That is, the capacity to make distinctions or vivek and uninterrupted insight are the path to the goal. That means the clear and distinct discriminative knowledge is the means of destruction of ignorance. So we can take Einstein's advice and shift the E side of the equation. Working at the level of energy frees us from the tyranny of the matter. And when we then address our problems at the level of cause rather than effect. So as we shift our attention from matter or the external attractions, we perceive the intelligence which is innate in energy. Detached consciousness opens us to the infinite possibilities contained in the universal field of infinite intelligence. When we are in the field of infinite possibilities, we are no longer bound by the limitedness of matter. When we do Ishwara Pranidhana and focus continually on the infinite consciousness and infinite energy, we create an entirely different life for us. Every moment we have a choice where to direct our consciousness. We can either focus on the drama of the world and the lure of the social media, or we can direct our attention to the eternal now and align our thoughts with the wisdom of universal mind. Scientific research into the brains of people who are in elevated spiritual states, it shows that they process the information very differently than those who function in ordinary consciousness. The ratio of delta, beta, alpha, theta and gamma waves, they change drastically as the brain functions in an entirely different way. With more neural connections to carry the information flow, the brain becomes better at picking up the signals from the universal field. There was a study performed by researchers at the University of Zurich, and it compared people who were making a choice about compassion and generosity. 50 participants were promised a sum of money at the start of the experiment. Half of the participants, they committed to spending the money on themselves alone. And the other half committed to spending it on someone else. Both groups were then asked to make a series of decisions indicative of generous behavior. The investigators then measured the brain activity after the decision-making process, and they found that the participants who chose to be compassionate and generous had the biggest changes in brain regions which were associated with happiness. The researchers were surprised that the mere intent to spend money on someone else was sufficient to trigger changes in the neural patterns. So we can choose to attune to the higher vibrational fields of love, of peace, generosity and compassion. Like selecting the stations in a radio, we can allow the instrument of our brain and our body to tune into the melodies of beauty and wonder. Our Vigyanmaya Kosh, or the intellect sheet, on the lower side, it is connected to our ego consciousness. It is called our lower mind. But the higher mind is connected to the universal mind, or the intuitive mind. And all the great discoveries in the world have happened by accessing the intuitive mind. When we align ourselves with the highest consciousness, we start tapping into the realm of intuition. When we align ourselves with these fields, they resonate through our worlds. We start experiencing synchronicities which lead us to the highest possibilities in our destiny. We are then able to become the best versions of ourselves. Success is not what you achieve materially, but true success is what you become in the process of achievement. I am your brother guide to prosperity, and my mission is to help you realize the dreams of your life and help you achieve something worthwhile in life for which your family, your parents, and your children can be proud of. We'll see you in my next video.